Did you think at all that you might have a shot today to play, or was it pretty much set in your mind that it wasn't?
Yeah, I'm just kind of taking it day to day. I think, and you know, I'm starting to feel more and more comfortable every day. And just working on timing and conditioning now, and it'll be soon. But you know, when that day comes, we'll let you know.
Pete talked a little bit about overcoming the mental hurdle because you came back once and it didn't, and you suffered a setback. Is that in your head right now? The concern of yet another setback?
Yeah, I think it's normal. I think it's just human nature. You know, came back and it didn't work out, and now coming back for a second time, you really want to make sure. You know, it is almost more mental than physical at this point. So, you know, you just have to, you know, put yourself in situations where you're going to get kind of knocked around, banged around, and you know, once you know you're all right and you know, you're healed, everything. I'm sure I'll get back out there, and you know, there'll be nothing bothering me mentally.
Travis, how many games do you feel like you need to get back into that groove, or I guess it's how many ever you get?
Well, the more the better would obviously be ideal, but without putting myself in a situation where I don't feel right on the ice, or I'm getting soreness or anything along those lines. So it's just a matter of balancing those two, getting as many games as possible, making sure I'm healthy and ready to go.
Are you getting sore? Are you sore now? Do you feel it after each game?
No, I feel pretty good. You know, it's nice this time. I can compete with how I felt last time. When I came out, I see a difference now. I really have no soreness or tightness or anything like that, swelling.
Thanks, Travis.
Yeah. Is that pretty much how it's been since you were shut down for that whole time?
What do you mean?
They shut you down for whatever it was, and then have you not had soreness since you came back, or is it as you built up the leg strength and everything?
Yeah, as I've gotten a little stronger, my balance got better, everything along those lines. I like I said, I haven't had the soreness or any swelling, which is probably the two biggest factors at this point. You know, if you don't have any of that, it's just getting comfortable. Like I said, that's the main thing, is I have to be comfortable on the ice to be able to do things that I was doing before I was injured.
When you were shut down, did they put you back in the boot again, or?
Yeah, just for precautionary, they put me back in the boot for I think it was 3.5 weeks.
Are you wearing any special pad now?
I wear a little bit of just a heel wedge. But other than that, that's just
that's doctor new, or is it normal?
Well, it's new. I started when I came back. I just the doctor mentioned that it might just be a good idea to throw it in there for now, just for the rest of the season. And I don't feel a difference with it, so it's like it's not even there.
It sucked to be back in the boot after you thought you probably were done with it.
Yeah, that was terrible, obviously. But you know, I think it just kept me off my leg a little more, and maybe helped the healing process a little better, maybe a little faster. So, I mean, it is what it is.
If you got to play 5 or 6 games plus all the skates and some practices, is that almost the equivalent of a build-up to opening night? I mean, you feel about the same going into the playoffs?
Yeah. I mean, I hope that would be enough. The game's a lot different now than when I came in the first time. I think it's the tempo's a lot faster. You know, there's not as much room out there. You can see some of the games are getting more low scoring. There's not as many chances. So I think, you know, my thought pattern is that it's I'll take it a game at a time when I do get in and try and, like I said, like you said, build myself up. So you know, when playoffs does come, I'm 100%.